kitchen, which is the most popular place in the luxury tour bus. And we're heading over here to the bathroom, which is so cool because we have like a hot tub. Look at this. Get a look at this. That's the hot tub, baby. Anyways, up next is an awesome band from Atlanta, Georgia called Cartel.
Hey, it's Will from Cartel, and you're watching the Rockstar Stories.
Everybody, now I'm here with one of the members from the band Cartel.
Indeed.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. How about you awesome. Give yourself a little introduction to everyone out there right now who's taking a look at what we're doing?
Hey, I'm Will. I'm the singer for Cartel. Prove it.
Very nice. I had to do little sunglasses.
Exactly. The sunglasses can hide a lot of things, you know?
They can. You could be an imposter. You know?
I could be an imposter, yes. You're part of the reason I'm so set on the rest of my life being a part of you. So tell me what you think about being open, about being honest with you.
Now, where are you guys going to next? You guys got another album coming out? Are you writing? Are you working on something big?
Or? We're touring with Newfound Glory in the fall, and then we're doing some headline dates between now and then. But, after that, like November, December, we're gonna sit down and really demo some stuff. And I've already demoed like 12 songs, so
we've got like a wide selection of something.
We're gonna have a lot of songs for the next record. Like Chroma, like it's like 14 songs that we wrote because it was really fast writing process. So.
Yourself in about 5 years?
Whew. Hopefully, you know, a couple records deep, many tours. I have toured the world by then. Hopefully, I don't know. Hopefully, still doing music, you know, that you never know, as volatile as the industry is and stuff like that. But hopefully, we're still able to do this. It'd be really cool. come to think of it, I worked at a place in Athens, Georgia, at UGA, it's where I went to school, that was called Junkman's Daughter's Brother. In Atlanta, there's a store called Junkman's Daughter, which is kind of like a big Hot Topic, but cooler, and like, there's only like two stores, you know? But they have like, you know, all the funny shirts and the band shirts, and then like your, you know, your peace pipes and stuff like that. But then the woman who started that, her brother opened a store in Athens, kind of the same thing, like novelty type store. So I worked there for like a year, and it was pretty funny because I was in college, always wearing, you know, just like band t-shirts and jeans and Converse, and they're walking in, your huge earrings, tattoos, and I'm like, man, I look just completely out of place here. But it was cool. It was a fun experience though. Got to sell some pretty weird things.
You guys just missed, I don't know if the camera saw it, but there was about four high school girls walked by staring at you. So, and once you see that, you know you're on your way up.
Oh, well, yeah. They're the ones who buy records. When 25-year-olds start buying records, I guess that will be the funny part.
One day.
Maybe they'll start buying records again. No, I understand, dude. You know, being broke in college or stuff like that, it's hard to buy a record, so no big deal. You know, like I said, you take what we can get. You put your music out there, as long as you love it, whoever likes it, that's who you have to love.
Exactly.
That's who you have to love.
People buy merch.
Yeah,
you know. Merch. Buy a shirt. Download the CD, but buy a shirt.
Exactly. Shirts help a lot more than CDs do for bands.
Talking to us.
Yeah, dude, thank you. Appreciate it.
And have a good rest of Warped Tour and everything else.